Hello children, hope you all are good and doing at the best of your health. So we are back with the rest of the chapter. What was the chapter that we were doing in English grammar? Prepositions, right? In which we learned that these are the words which actually or basically talks about the position of a noun or a pronoun or a noun phrase, right? So you have already done 4 exercises. Yesterday you have done 2 exercises. You have sent me the those exercises for checking. I have checked it and I have returned you back. Now today we are going to learn one more new aspect related to this chapter called preposition, order and place, right? So in this today, what we are going to learn, we are going to learn about the order of preposition. How does the preposition appear or where it is to be placed and what is that is to be followed, right? So for which we have already learned, we already know about it, that it follows, it is followed by a noun or a noun phrase, and before that we have an adjective or an adverb. So we have learnt about this. So to add on to that, there is some more thing that we need to learn, is this, that the noun phrase or the pronoun that follows the preposition is the object of the preposition. Now here it says that the noun phrase or the pronoun that follows the preposition is known as to be the object of the preposition. Now this term object, in this term object, I think we have done one chapter, objects, right? Objects of verb, we have learnt about that. So you have a brief idea about what there are 2 types of objects. One is the direct object and the other one is the indirect object, right? And both these objects deals with what? Nouns, right? So similarly over here also, the moment this word comes object, it is basically talking about noun, right? So see, in the first part of this sentence which I just read out, it also says the same thing, the noun phrase or pronoun that follows the preposition is the object of the preposition. So object of the object of the preposition. Now we are here to find out the object of the preposition, and what are those? It will be either a noun or a noun phrase or a pronoun. Now let us see this example that I have given. In example it says that they walked into the disco. Now in order to find out or locate the object in the sentence which is followed by a, or which follows a preposition, first of all, first thing first that we need to do is to identify the preposition in the sentence. But remember, it is not necessary that all the sentences that you read or you come across are do have prepositions in it, right? There can be sentences where there is no preposition, right? So in this sentence, they walked into the disco. So what did I tell you? We got to find out the preposition from here. So what is the preposition? Any idea? Well, let us also recap of the things or the chapters that we have done it before. Now they, what is they? If you are thinking it's a pronoun, yes, they falls under the category of pronoun. Walked, walked, walked falls in which part of, which part of speech? Verb, yes, correct. Verb into, into, into falls under which category of parts of speech that we have learned? If you are thinking it falls under the category of preposition, you are correct. Here into is the preposition. So first of all, we have to identify the preposition in order to find the object of the preposition. This is the object related to the preposition, remember, right? And then whatever it is said that follows means behind, comes after. So what comes after? The disco. So here the disco is the object of the preposition, right? So the disco is the object of the preposition. Now this the disco falls under which category? Noun, noun phrase or pronoun? It falls under the category of noun phrase, right? So in the first sentence we have identified, in the second sentence I'm giving you 30 seconds, try to identify and then I will tell you the answers. If your answer is correct or it is similar to the answer which I am giving, then you have understood what are the objects of preposition. So your time starts now. The sentence says, we all prayed during the assembly, right? So think about it. Okay, time is up for you to check now whether what you thought is correct or not. Here, during is the preposition, because during is talking about preposition of time, if you remember, right? So during is the preposition of time. Now it also says followed by, right? So it is followed by what? The assembly, or the assembly. So here again, this is the object of preposition, right? So this is how we identify the object of preposition. Next, here in simple sentences or in other sentences, positive sentences or affirmative sentences, we get to identify the prepositions like this. Now, you see, there is another statement over here which says the preposition need not be followed, remember, by an object in an interrogative sentence. Now, what is an interrogative sentence? Any idea? A sentence which has got a question mark at the end and starts with WH, right? So it sometimes starts with verb also, auxiliary verb, right? So we are talking about interrogative sentence. So what it says, it will not follow. What it will not follow? There may not be any noun or noun phrase or pronoun if it is an interrogative sentence. After what? After the preposition. For example, where did you come from? What is the preposition present in this sentence? Quickly. This is the preposition, right? From is the preposition. Now it falls under which category of preposition? Preposition of time, place, or preposition of what you call direction? That you got to identify. Check your book, you will get the answer. So where did you come from? Here you see, this is an interrogative sentence. From is the preposition and it says need not be followed. So is there any object after that? No. So in interrogative sentence, we do not have objects of preposition, right? So in the next example, who are you waiting for? So who are you waiting for? Over here, this is a question and we have learned for is a preposition. So this is the preposition, and since it is an interrogative sentence, so it is not followed by the object of preposition. So these are the two types that we need to remember, right? So based on this, there is an exercise. There are two exercises, but what we will do today, we will be doing exercise F, that is on page number 5. So you have to do exercise number F and you have to send me, right? I have put up three examples or three sentences from your exercise. We will discuss about this and I will tell you how to go about it. Let's see sentence number 1. We sat among dash for a picture. So you sat among means with all or with the other things. So it can be, it is your choice what you can. But if you ask me, I will give you an example. Say for example, we sat among the flowery bushes. We sat among the flowery bushes for a picture, right? So here you see, among is the preposition, right? And the flowery bushes is the object. It is in the form of noun phrase. Again, for is also a preposition. Again, it is followed by an object, right? So let us come to the next sentence, which is there in your exercise F, page number 105. The soldiers were on high alert during what? You can write down during the war, right? So during the war, over here during is the preposition and followed by an object. So this is supposed to be the object of the preposition, right? So the soldiers were on high alert during the war. You can write down curfew, or the soldiers were on high alert during the difficult days, all right? Or during the flood, you can add on to that. But remember, you can add what? You can add either a noun or a noun phrase or a pronoun in these blanks in exercise number F. This here I have written number 3, but I think it is the 10th sentence in your book. It says that we did not realize, R-E-A, sorry, the spelling of realize, I got to correct it. We did not realize we had walked towards. You have to put a noun phrase, or you have to put a noun also will do. Towards what? I am writing little scary. Sometimes we get scared. So towards the graveyard. Right? So it is up to you, but remember these are the forms in which you can write. Over here in the last sentence I have written the graveyard. You can write down towards the busy road or towards the pond, right? Or towards the something, towards the jungle maybe, towards the forest. It is up to you, but remember you have to follow this, right? So this is your work today. You got to complete this and send it to me by 7 p.m. today. That's it for today. Thank you. And bye-bye.